Hello friends, welcome to my channel Pathology Master. Myself Dr. Parth Goswami, and today I will give you a very short tutorial on what is emperipolesis. So guys, emperipolesis means presence of one cell into the another cell. So in the cytoplasm of one cell, you will have the presence of another intact cell. This cell is totally intact without any degradation. So the emperipolesis means the active penetration of one cell into the another cell. And the etiopathogenesis for emperipolesis is not clearly understood. Now guys, in this diagram you can see that this is the large cell. This large cell is megakaryocyte. Why? Because here you can see certain cytoplasmic blobs. So the future platelets will produce from these cytoplasmic protrusions. So this is the megakaryocyte cell, and here in this diagram you can see that megakaryocyte has engulfed a neutrophil. This is the neutrophil. So megakaryocyte engulfed the neutrophil here. That is the example of emperipolesis. Alright, now you might have questioned that such cell engulfment is also seen in phagocytosis. Then how this emperipolesis is differ from the phagocytosis? So guys, you have to remember that in the emperipolesis, the engulfed cell is totally viable and it will not degrade. It means it exists without any physiological and morphological change. So here you can see that this neutrophil doesn't have any morphological change, and it is the intact cell within the megakaryocytes. So that is the difference from the phagocytosis. If you remember the phagocytosis, then you can have idea that in the phagocytosis, the cell is getting destructed by the hydrolytic enzymes. But here it is not happening. Alright. Now based on engulfment of the different variety of cell, it can be divided into two categories. Either you can have engulfment of inflammatory cell by the histiocytes, or you can have engulfment of hematopoietic cells like that of red blood cell, neutrophils by megakaryocytes. So these are the two classification, and the different disease is associated according to the variety. So we will see each category with the example one by one. So first category, first classification is you can have the engulfment of inflammatory cell by the histiocytes. Alright, see guys, here you can see the presence of lymphocytes. Sorry, here you can see the presence of lymphocytes. This arrow area is your lymphocyte. Alright, and this lymphocyte is engulfed by this large cell. This large cell has engulfed the lymphocyte. So guys, here the histiocyte has engulfed the lymphocytes. So this is the example of engulfment of inflammatory cell, particularly of lymphocyte, by the histiocytes. Why it is histiocytes? Because the histiocytes means macrophage is having the foamy cytoplasm. Here you can see that cytoplasm is very clear and foamy. So here the macrophage has engulfed the lymphocytes, and such emperipolesis is seen in one disease, that is Rosy-Dorfman disease. So it's an example, it's a case of Rosy-Dorfman disease. Alright, now in the another group of classification, you can have engulfment of hematopoietic cells by the megakaryocytes. We have seen earlier in the first slide that megakaryocyte has engulfed the neutrophil. This is the another image. Here you can see that this large cell, this is the megakaryocyte, has engulfed the neutrophil. So such engulfment of hematopoietic cell by megakaryocytes is seen in following conditions. It can be seen in Hodgkin and non-Hodgkin lymphomas. It can be seen in myeloproliferative neoplasm like that of acute myeloid leukemia, chronic myeloid leukemia, and the myelodysplastic syndrome. Guys, emperipolesis sometimes also has been observed in autoimmune hepatitis and in the multiple sclerosis. So guys, this is all about the emperipolesis. Hope you can understand that emperipolesis means engulfment of one cell by another cell. And here the engulfed cell will be viable and will be morphologically and physiologically normal. It will not get destroyed. It's the intact cell engulfment. And it is seen in such condition like that of Rosette Hoffmann, then certain myeloid leukemias, then myelodysplastic syndrome, Hodgkin, non-Hodgkin lymphomas, and sometime in the autoimmune hepatitis and multiple sclerosis.